Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. In today's video, we are going to learn about how to send an image to any Telegram group using Telegram bot. And also in this lesson, we are not going to download any image. We are just going to directly send an image from any URL. Okay, so it's very easy on Telegram and I'm going to show you how to do it. Now this request has come from one of the followers of my channel. So that's why I'm creating this video. And after this video also, if you have any doubt, please feel free to write in the comment section. Now if you see here on the screen, what I have done is initially obviously you need to have requests module because we are going to make a request, okay, to APIs. So that's the reason we need to have request module, and after that we need to have token. Your token again is your token, whatever is your Telegram bot token, you need to give it here. So this bot you are going to create using Botfather, which I have already shown you many times in previous videos, so I'm not going to show that again now. And in base URL, we are telling what is the base URL of Telegram API. Okay, so that's all here. And after that, if we see, this is the function which we have created, which is called send photo function. And then we have put a try and accept block. And in the try block, we have a payload. So if you don't know payload is basically the data which you are going to send when you are calling an API. Okay, so in this scenario, we are going to call an API to send a photo to any Telegram group, and along with that we also need to send some data. Okay, so what is the data which we need to send? So if you go to this Telegram documentation and if you read about that how you can send a photo, then it tells you that in order to send a photo you need to send chat ID, you need to send photo, and you need to send caption. Again, caption is optional, and you can see required field is only chat ID and photo, okay, which is mentioned here on the screen. Now one interesting thing which you see here in photo is that it says you can just pass an HTTP URL as a string, and then Telegram is automatically going to pull the image and going to send it to the sender. Okay, so you don't have to download the image on your local computer and then send it to anyone. Okay, so it's very easy. You're just going to give the reference of the URL and Telegram is automatically going to download the image and send it. So now let's go back to the program and see again how it works. Okay, so here now if you see, there are three things which I shown you, that we need to give chat ID, we need to give a photo. So in photo we have given URL of the photo. So this is one of the URL from Unsplash. If you don't know about Unsplash is like basically an image inventory. There are lots and lots of video images available there on that website, which you can go and download for any purpose. Now in caption, you can give any caption. It is optional, but if you want to give any caption when you are sending an image, you can do that here as well. Now next to that, we have two URLs. So again, it's just a variable where I'm saying, okay, this is the, you know, Telegram API and we are calling send photo. Okay, so send photo is the endpoint. Now again, if you go to the documentation, you can see here clearly that it's send photo. So that's why we are using send photo here. And now we are going to make a request. Okay, so we are making a post request here because we are also going to send the data. And then we are saying two URL. So two URL is basically, this is a URL and data is going to be equal to payload. Okay, so we are passing this payload. Now this chat ID is of this group, which is YouTube demo group. So if I run this program, it is going to download or basically it is going to send a travel photo on this group. Okay, because this URL is of a travel photo. Now let me run this program and see how it works. As you can see, as soon as I executed this program, we have received a photo here saying here is a travel photo for you. Okay, now this is a very, you know, flat example. In this example, if you see, we are really, you know, just we have hard coded an image URL and then we are sending to the user, or basically sending on a Telegram group. But typically this is not something which you would like to do. Typically what you would like to do is that you might have a group or channel or whatever, and then you are going to receive some keywords from users. So for example, let's say you want user to send age or travel or nature. Basically you want user to make some request based on the keywords, and then you are going to pull that, you know, image, or you are going to search that image with a keyword which user has sent in Unsplash, and then you are going to send that image on that group. Okay, so I have already written the full program. Again, probably I'm going to explain the full program in detail in next video, but in this video I'm just going to give you some hint on what I have done and how I have made it. And then also I will run it and show you how it works. So here, if you see, I have actually grabbed all the keywords. So if you see, I wanted to search image related to nature, travel, age and computer. And then, you know, with the help of Beautiful Soap, which is again web scraping, with the help of that we pulled all the URLs, okay, related to nature, travel, age and computer photos, and then we put everything in the list. So here if you see, this is the list which has all the URL along with the keywords. So here if you see, for nature there is one URL, then similarly for nature there is other images available as well. So for example, I may randomly want to send photo related to nature, based on from person to person, user to user, or probably from group to group. Okay, so we have kept all the data here. This is again one time job, you don't need to run this every time. So once you make list of all the URLs, and after that you are going to run the program. So here again, if you see, this program reply message is pretty much same what I have shown you here, but I have here made things dynamic. Okay, so here I have added few more things. For example, if you see URL, this is the hard-coded URL which I have now commented, and URL is going to be URL, image URL, which is going to be coming from this data. Okay, so now I'm going to look for the keyword. So I'm going to ask user to send any keyword. For example, they can select, they can send slash nature, they can send us slash travel, slash age, slash computer, and then user is going to get related image. Okay. And this program is running on Flask. So if you don't know about Flask, Flask is basically going to give you functionality to run your APIs, okay, or your APIs basically. So I'm just going to run it, and sorry, is it running? Okay, I'm just going to run it now, and now you can see this is running. Here you can see the processing, you know, it's been processing. Now in this group I'm going to send, let's say I'm going to send slash nature, okay, that I want a photo related to nature, and hit enter, and now hopefully it is going to send us an image related to nature. Okay, now you can see we have got an image related to nature. Now let's say there is another user who's going to send a different keyword, and he's going to write travel slash travel, hit enter, and now we are going to see a photo related to travel. Okay, so you see how based on just a simple keyword, our program is automatically going on Unsplash, pulling the image and sending to the user. So this is how you can make something interesting, something interactive. And this kind of, once you download the photo, you may also, you know, dynamically add some, let's say some watermark in the images, that it has been automatically downloaded or automatically served by your bot, okay, something like that. And also you can create, you know, several different type of bots. For example, let's say if somebody have, you know, some image with some background, and they want to, they send that image to you, and then you process it using Telegram bot, you remove the background image, and then you send the image back to the user. Okay, so this is something like image removal bot. Okay, so you can create something like that as well. So that's it in this video. If video was helpful, do let me know in the comment section. And I'm going to give this program, I'm going to keep this program on GitHub so you can see this as well. If you need more information on any of the topic, please feel free to write to me. I'll be more than happy to create a video and explain it to you in more detail. So thank you so much for watching. See you again in the next video.